a fakir. Not on this earth, not in the world above, a fakir lives, caught between two worlds, like a hungry Kalahandi farmer, singing abhangas of Vitthala's people, a mahar of Mangalveda. A vankar he weaves, a chadar so fine, a kabir of our times. On the loom of words, khatak, khatkhat, khatak, khatkhat, weaving stories of silence, truths, he pulls a fine thread, brings palaces of falsehood crumbling down. A fakir sits beneath a tree and tells a bold tale. Many episodes, many chapters, many tales within a tale of farmers without land, with drought-filled sighs, and orange-colored tales of angry, sleepy little eyes. A row of women so long lift and dump and break the heavy loads of lives. Bent on the blazing earth, they gather their crawling luck. Old smiling faces of foot soldiers of freedom fill his dark tales with light. A fakir tells a story of dreams shimmering in the night.
Sainath, my younger colleague and friend, for pretty much the whole of his journalistic career of 40 years and counting. It's widely acknowledged that he's a versatile and world-class journalist, one of the very best India has ever produced. India, which has a rich history of purposeful and impactful journalism. Sainath's published work, the many awards that have come his way, the respect and esteem in which he is held wherever serious, relevant, people-oriented journalism is valued, testify to this. Sainath is so generous. He's first and foremost a reporter who has traveled the long, hard road, literally tens of thousands of kilometers, to investigate and uncover truths about the lives of working people that are seldom presented in the so-called mainstream media. Sainath is an independent spirit who can't be tied down to an editor's desk. This became clear to me when, as editor of The Hindu, I pressured and persuaded him, using every trick in my book, to take up the full-time job of rural affairs editor. Full-time in this case meant being on the road, rather than in our Mumbai bureau, of which he was chief, for close to 300 days in the year. Sainath is a highly disciplined professional who works with facts and evidence, is actually committed to a higher calling, that of a journalist of conscience, integrity, and moral independence, who takes sides, being constantly on the side of the people, the deprived, the exploited, the oppressed, including those living at the very margins of society. Sainath's approach to or attitude to journalism, in my view, is best summed up in the words of James Cameron, the distinguished foreign correspondent, as he puts it provocatively in his book, An Indian Summer. Cameron says that facts must never be allowed to get in the way of truth, by which he explains that so-called objectivity is of less importance than the truth, and that the reporter, whose technique is informed by no opinion, quote, lacks a very serious dimension, end quote. Journalists, therefore, Cameron notes, are professionally obliged to present their attitude as vigorously and persuasively as they can, to be set out for consideration, criticism, and debate. Being scrupulous about this is a vital ingredient of moral independence. Among other things, Cameron goes on to explain, this involves an attitude of mind that will challenge and criticize automatically, thus to destroy or weaken the built-in advantages of all propaganda and special pleading, including the journalist's own. I can say a few more things about Sinnott's contribution to journalism and the media. He's imaginative, and he's a pioneer in other forms of the media. And PARI, the People's Archive of Rural India, is a wonderful ongoing project. It's collected very rich material, visual material, as well as various facts that are presented in an impactful way, and I think it's a new trend in our journalism. Sinnott has also contributed to journalism as a teacher in Sophia College in Mumbai, and in our Asian College of Journalism in Chennai and so forth, and also in foreign universities, where he's a much valued teacher of journalism. On the personal side, I want to highlight one thing. Sinnott lives very simply with his wife Sonia. They lead exemplary and simple lives, supporting each other in the work they do, respecting each other. This is, I think, a model for all young people. And you really have to visit their home or see them at work to realize the quality of this. This is very special for me. The other important trait of Sinnott is his generosity, his public-spiritedness, because a lot of cash prize has come his way through these awards. And as far as I know, invariably, he gives this to the projects, the causes that he is involved in, so that that work is strengthened and becomes more impactful. So I think these are qualities that are very rare in the field of Indian journalism. And on this occasion, when we mark 40 years of Sinnott's journalism, I want to wish him the best. And I want young people to learn from his journalism, his lifestyle, his integrity, his moral independence. And also, I want to highlight the fact that this is the kind of journalism that will endure.
P. Sinnott is the most important photographer in this country and for this country. His contribution to the situation of rural India over the last four decades is like nobody else. I think if we didn't have Sinnott, I don't know how much we would have known of what really happened in India. And what I love about Sinnott is that he never ever robs anyone of their dignity, however desperate the situation may be. And often the stories he's reporting on are the most extreme. But I never feel that he's robbed anyone of their dignity. And that's really something very important to learn from him. And PARI runs on the same principles. So PARI is something we all have to support, not just financially, but also with all our skills. Wish you all the best, Sinnott.
40 years ago, Sinnott forged a new path in journalism. He actually made rural India the focus of study, brought public attention to it, showed the realities at a time when it was not just unpopular, it was actually even vilified. What's amazing is that despite all the constraints over the years, he has managed not just to keep doing this incredible work, but train several generations of young people who are showing similar enthusiasm and integrity. More power to him and all his friends.
Sainath, they said that you've finished 40 years of journalism. And my first reaction was, what? Only 40 years? The man who single-handedly changed the way reporting happens in rural India has only been doing this for 40 years? Give me a break.
In the early 1990s, I was teaching at NID and I invited Sainath for a 1 week long course. On Monday morning, he had 26 students in his class, which was the strength of the class. On Friday evening, it had swelled to 158. That's Sainath, wowing young people, inspiring them for 40 years.
I think the best teacher I've ever had, even though I went away later to New York, really still the best teacher I've ever had. And you taught us how to see. You've been a huge inspiration. We're all really proud of you. But more than anything else, you've been a wonderful friend. You've responded to so many of my work emergencies. You've saved my life at least twice. Like the time when you came running down to Gaylord's when I was in Outlook, or you stopped me from quitting journalism after Avantika was born. So thank you, Sainath. We love you to bits. And now I've been so nice to you, I'm going to have to be very nasty to you for a few days.
Well, there are many things that I have learned from Sainath, sir, over a period of time. And I can go on and on of what I've learned. But if I were to sum up one important lesson that has remained with me and that remains dear to me, is what he said during one of our journeys. You know, he said, Jaideep, you can't see a story if you don't have a heart. It was paraphrased by him later during a public talk in Nagpur itself. And it's a beautiful lesson. He said, your eyes cannot see what your heart doesn't feel. A good journalist or a good rural reporter or a good crime reporter or any reporter, the prerequisite is that you ought to be a good human being. Another thing that I really, really value in him is how he treats his fellow journalists, young journalists, senior journalists, journalists of his age, or journalists who are just beginning their career. He gives them a lot of respect. It's very, very rare. It's very rare to find this quality in a human being. And that is why I feel that he is a good journalist, because he is a very good human being. He makes you comfortable even if you are just at the beginning of your career. That is something that I think is invaluable.
Sainath sir, mere liye friend, philosopher aur guide hain. Main किसी कॉलेज या यूनिवर्सिटी में कम और साइना सर के साथ हिंदुस्तान के उड़ीसा, छत्तीसगढ़, आंध्र प्रदेश, तेलंगाना जैसे राज्यों में आदिवासी इलाकों में साथ में लंबी यात्राओं पर जाकर लोगों से मिलकर जर्नलिज्म सीखा। साइना सर को इसलिए और भी धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा कि उन्होंने परी जैसे एक संस्था की स्थापना की है, जिसके चलते मेरे जैसे उन तमाम पत्रकार जिनके लिए मेनस्ट्रीम मीडिया में स्पेस नहीं है, जो आम आदमी की कहानी, ग्रामीण भारत की कहानी को लिखना चाहते हैं, उनके लिए एक बहुत बड़ा स्पेस और प्लेटफॉर्म मिल गया है। और आज भारत के बहुत सारे युवा सर से इंस्पायर हो रहे हैं, इसलिए मैं ये कहूँगा कि सर मेरे लिए कल भी इंस्पिरेशन थे, आज भी हैं और आने वाले कल भी रहेंगे।
Hi Sainath, wishing you a very, very happy 40th year in journalism. And I can't believe it's been 21 years since you taught me at SCM. You inspired me then and you inspire me now. You are amazing and I'm so happy that you thought of me and included me in the Parivar. To many, many, many more years of fantastic journalism and of course a lot of fun with puns.
You know, words fall short to describe Sainath's impact on all of us as students. We were the batch that he was teaching when he was reporting on his series on India's poorest districts, and we really got the benefit of him being on the field and coming back and talking to us, you know. And yes, of course, Sainath is always such a mesmerizing speaker. His ability, his analysis, his ability to decode data, all of that. But I think what stayed with me the most, what resonated with me the most, was his emotional response to every story he wrote about. I would get moved just listening to him speak, and this is something I continue to feel when I worked with him on Nero's Guest, that how consumed and how much he feels for what he's writing about. And I think that is why he's such an important voice, because
the communities that he chooses to represent, he feels so deeply for them. And I think that was something I learned for life, that if you want to write and do something with meaning, it has to have that emotional connect. So I'm really grateful to Sainath for that one lesson, he's also somebody whom I've observed being so consumed by his work, whether it's journalistic writing and now Pari. It overwhelms him, and that is something again I've learned from, that if you really want to go deep and be really good at what you do, it's by completely getting immersed in that work. And for these two lessons, I'm ever grateful for Sainath, besides of course having found a friend for life.
Sainath's been a teacher, a mentor, a fellow journalist, a sounding board, a critique, but I think for me personally, a moral compass of sorts. It feels like yesterday when I wrote in Sainath Nama, when I think you completed 25 years in journalism, and it's 40 already. Journalism needs you more than ever before, Sainath. So I wish you all the health, all the strength, all my love, and all my regards.
Kind of answers it demands, not only from those in power but from all of us in society. Yours is an extremely committed, empathetic, humane voice in journalism. It's moved everyone. It's from prime ministers, it's persuaded a prime minister to institute a study group on farmer suicide. It's moved people across the globe on issues on the most pitiable conditions of some of the poorest Indians who are off the radar of conventional mainstream media. So whether it was the last page in the Blitz, which the legendary K.A. Abbas bequeathed to you all those many years ago, or Pari, what remains consistent in your work is that commitment to become the voice of those who are most voiceless, and do that with an incredible degree of integrity and humane ness to it all. I feel proud to have known you the way I do, to have been associated with some of your earliest work on the subject, with your book, and I of course wish you all the very, very, very best. Keep that voice strong. We need it. Happy work anniversary.
Hi Sainath, congratulations on completing 40 years of your journalism. I must say that you have been a wonderful teacher. You have influenced so many people, so many students, not just students, but me as well. I really admire the way you have worked and taught and written. I'm also very happy that you had come once to show me all the awards that you had got. I was very happy every time you got an award. So congratulations and all the very best.
Whenever I think I know something, I just have to ask Sainath, and I discover I know nothing about the subject.
P. Sainath is an institution himself. To me, he is the epitome of simplicity, reliability, trust, and most importantly, credibility. I still remember the date when I first met him here in Shantiniketan, 2014. Yes, the year when Pari was launched. Wishing him all the very best on the completion of his 40 years of journalism.
Sainath, you're so outstanding a journalist and a writer, editor, teacher and a leader. You're a great leader. The way you lead all of us at Pari with so much patience and generosity. And I learn so much from you every day. I wish you many more years of writing books, stories and journalism. Your journalism.
Happy journalism anniversary, Sainath. Exactly 7 years ago, I listened to your first lecture in Kalakshetra. A day before that, you had signed this copy of your book for me. Thank you for all the learning, for inviting me to be a part of Pari, for being such an incredible and patient teacher. Wishing you many, many more years of journalism and storytelling, And I look forward to learning from you always. Thank you.
One of the biggest things Sainath as a mentor gave me was for me to realize that idealism, optimism, a good intention were not naive endeavors, that these had a very just place in society, in the world, that one needn't be ashamed of such thoughts, that one could follow through and be successful. And that, Sainath, did save my life. I know I will probably not say it again if you ask me to, so this is just the once. But Sainath, I think I might just owe you my life.
What can I add? Sainath, you have defined rural journalism not just for journalists like me, but for the world around. Your writing is so compassionate, so empathetic, and so democratic. You really walk the talk. So please keep walking for all of us.
Hey Sainath, though I have never been a student of yours, yet I have been learning from you right from my formative years. Your articles changed the way I perceive things around me. I grew critical about the idea of ownership and became aware of my locational privileges. And I could never imagine a life disconnected from the realities of my country. I used to think, how could a person with the background of literature and much of professional life into archiving could work with you? And when Pari happened, I told myself, hey, now you cannot have an excuse. You got exactly what you wanted. And in mid-2017, a phone call saying, hey Smita, this is Sainath, changed my life. Thank you, Bossman, for creating an inclusive space where people like me who are not journalists could find equal sense of belonging. Love you, Sainath.
Sainath's influence in my life in 30 seconds will be very tough. Neither I am not a very good speaker. So all what I like to say is, sir, thank you for everything.
Working with Sainath is like being put on a path that is full of purpose and sometimes can be scary and challenging, and sometimes he'll push you off a cliff. But he'll always make sure that there's a safety net, and he'll never let you get lost on your own. If you need help, you can always reach out and he'll provide a map. And I think for me, I have grown so much in the last 5 years on this path. And it is one of the most rewarding, life-changing experiences that I've ever had. Thank you, Sainath. Thank you for your trust, and thank you for showing us this path.
Sainath, I have a very fundamental question for you. How are you not tired? Anyway, we are all glad that you're not tired, and I've said this before and I'll keep repeating it, that working with you and Pari has been the best thing that could have happened to me as a journalist. So thank you for being what you are, and I wish you another 40 years in journalism. Thanks a lot.
Excerpts from Homes to a Hijack, Firdausi of Foot Soldiers. In these 4 decades, you have been a journalist, and teacher's teacher. You have taught scores of students, albeit from the most parasitic strata of Indian and American society, the most meaningful way in which to engage with the world around them. You have taught them that the real action lies not in the make-believe tinsel of the so-called beautiful people, but in the everyday lives of everyday people. Their work, their voices. Our work, our voices. that poverty is not a sad condition that the rich can donate their way out of. It is a political act of depriving, perpetrated by an elite through its cruel policies. In this, you have been standing on the shoulders of giants, but in this, you have made those good old white boys walk halfway across the planet and made them alive for us darker nations. When today one reads your story on Captor Elder Brother, one is forced to wonder if we will ever achieve those dreams that Bhau saw. In fact, in these grim days, one sadly wonders if this republic will even survive. But looking at People's Archive of Rural India, your most momentous creation, one gets a glimpse of a new generation of idealistic visionaries. Public-spirited young men and women who are ready to take considerable personal risks to have a structured, meaningful, and prolonged conversation with their society. You have inspired, tutored, and nurtured this crop, and it is blossoming in ever-rising numbers. This gives us hope. I believe this is your greatest achievement. May your tribe exceed.
Not only is he a great boss, he is a great friend to each and every member of Bari. And he, Palguni Sainath, has taught me how to dig deep into the story and get emotion into it and play a role in the story. And that's why I would like to wish him a 40th anniversary of 40 years of journalism and Bari.
I'm Kent Brockman, and that's all for today. Stay tuned to Channel 6 News to see how much sugar Pari consumes in 1 year.
Most of us at Pari office made our way here because somewhere in a classroom or bookshelves or through conversations, you chanced upon Sainath's journalism.
Thank you for lending us your vision through Pari, where every day we unlearn and learn how to see.
Made us see and hear the India we live in. The one the mainstream media feverishly avoids.
Notice the history being made and lost in the countryside.
Thank you for trusting us and motivating us to continue reporting.
And thank you for all the sugar.
Happy 40 years in journalism, Sainath.
Love you, Sainath. Everybody loves a good boss.